There was uproar in Parliament today as the debate on the 6 billion presidential handshake to government officials kicked off. The motion was moved by Mbarara Municipality MP Michael Tsime.
Right, Honourable Speaker, I move a motion, a resolution of Parliament to investigate the circumstances under which rewards were made for the two public officers for winning the tax arbitration case between the government of Uganda and Heritage Oil and Gas.
Shortly into the reading of the motion, the Deputy Attorney General, on a point of procedure, took to the floor and said his office had been served a court order restraining Parliament from investigating, questioning or inquiry into the bonus payment.
I thought it prudent to seek procedural guidance on how we proceed. Because once there is a court order, it is a court order. I am prepared in your hands. I have to bring it to your notice because there is a court order. I would like to know how we as the presenting proceed.
MPs ruled the Attorney General out of order, quoting the Powers of Parliament and Privileges Act on the invalidity of the court order.
Speaker, that in some cases the office of the Attorney General has been failing Parliament.
After a series of back and forth discussions with the Deputy Attorney General, the Speaker ruled that the Attorney General move to court and have the court order reversed.
We should not inquire, we should not investigate. That's unacceptable. Honourable Member, there is no way we shall deal with the budget without talking about this matter. There is no way the government will secure the money from the petroleum fund without talking about this matter. There is no way you are going to capitalize UDP without talking about this matter. So, Honourable Member, I want to direct the Attorney General to move to court immediately and get this stupid order vacated.
Kadaga also ruled that no business shall be conducted in Parliament until the court order is withdrawn.
I would adjourn the committee of this House sign die from today. No more work to be done. Adjourn the plenary sign die until we have vacated this order.
The move by the Speaker to adjourn committees and plenary sign die was applauded by legislators.
And they brought the court order in anticipation, which is not really correct. And at the same time, the rules of procedure give permission to the Speaker of Parliament to make a judgment on whether to accept the court order or not.
It's been a test of time. It has given us, it has been a test of good precedents or bad precedents. But today we've won because the doctrine of separation of powers indicates that the Parliament is supposed to execute its work.
That there is no way we can sit back to see an individual using an office, a public office, abuse the powers of Parliament that are derived from the mandate Ugandans give to members of Parliament.
I think it was an order in collusion. The Office of Attorney General colluded and actually discussed the application and the court order before going to court.
However, what does this mean for parliamentary business?
Means that parliamentary businesses has been put on hold. Even businesses that should be discussed in parliament from the executive has been put on hold. All bills under considerations, loans that should be approved by parliament, debates on ministerial statements, even the budget process itself.
Maurice Ochol, NTV at Parliament.